The following video is intended for people over the age of 13. Viewer discretion is advised.
Today we'll be having another drama presentation. But just a reminder that during the presentation, everybody should be perfectly still, no interruptions, because anything you do can affect the performance. Okay, so be very still. Do not clap until the very end. Okay? And they will indicate when it's appropriate to clap. Right at the very end, when everything is all over. Okay? Today we'll be talking about the power of the tongue, or the power of words. Words can be wonderful. They can bring healing. But words can also be poisonous, like a venomous snake, like a knife that stabs the heart. Words can be like music that brings butterflies to the stomach. When I was a little kid, when the girls were arguing, I would often hear them say, "Well, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can never hurt me." I come to discover that is not true at all, because sometimes words can hurt far deeper, far more painfully than sticks or stones. In fact, the Bible, in Proverbs 18, verse 21, says that the tongue has the power of life and death. Can you believe it? Life and death. So today, there are a number of things that we want that you will learn as we watch this skit, as we listen to this presentation. Because you have a lot of influence among your peers. I've seen students crying because others have said nasty things about them. In fact, just this week, one man was saying that he never seen his sister cry so hard, not since she was a child. What happened? Her brother said some unkind things about her in the presence of others. She cried so hard because the words cut her deeply. So words can be good or bad. Let me show you an illustration. Would somebody come here? I need a volunteer, Mr. Horowitz. This here represents you. This could represent your heart, your feelings, your emotions. And this represents your words, or your actions, or your attitude. So you may say something that's unkind and harsh. Painful, and it rips his heart apart. But you know what? You see him crying, and you see him looking very sad, very depressed and gloomy. And you feel so sorry that you gossiped about him, that you made nasty remarks about his parents, and you feel so sorry, so then you apologize and say, "Oh, I'm so sorry, I'll never do this again." So you take away those harsh words. But look at his heart. What you can't take away is the damage that you've caused. You could try to put tape over it. You could try to fix it. But the damage is already there. It can never be repaired. Thank you.
Let's go on another one.
Okay guys, we're going to go over the quiz now. I hope you copy the questions. We're going to go over the quiz we had yesterday. Quiz on chapter 5, okay? Hey Sarah, are you okay? Is she okay? Oh, okay. Okay, we're going to go over this quiz right now, okay? Make sure that you raise your hand to answer the question. Okay, the first question we had was, what is the meaning of the name Melchizedek? Alejandra, what is that, Alejandra? Okay, very good, Alejandra. Very good. Make sure that you put your participation points there. Okay, I have another question for you. Okay, we have been talking about the origins of Jesus Christ. Sarah, I need to see your face, Sarah. What's happened to you? Okay, look at me. What thing happened to her? Oh man, I have one more question for you guys here. Okay.
I'm so bored.
Hey, you two, what are you guys talking about there? I already told you guys to have sit together.
Yeah. Stop laughing.
I don't talk to me. Let it talk to me. Let it rain. Let me talk to me. Come on. Shawty had the apple bottom jeans.
Move. Jeez, I'm trying to move. What do you think? You got two chairs.